We just saw in our previous example, like we used a default case after several switch case within a switch case statement. So our very next question is a default case necessary in a switch case switch statement? So I will explain it to you with a small example based on we have a condition like we may have to input yes, Y, press Y for this thing for saying yes, answering yes, or press N for answering no. There are two possibilities like you can go with a capital Y or a small Y. You can there are cases like we may end up with the capital Y or small Y. So here we can go ahead with the switch case statement. So, I will answer you as it is not necessary to have a default case statement, but it is not a bad idea to put default statement in switch statement, switch case statement for error or logic checking purposes. For instance, the following switch statement is perfectly normal, as I explained it to you. So case Y, capital Y, case small Y, printf, you answered yes or break, or case N, I mean capital N or a small N, printf, you answer no, break. Here the question comes is what if I press something else apart from capital Y, small Y, capital N, small N, suppose I pressed in percentage T. We require to have something like this is an error happened. This is an unknown thing which happened. So based upon this char code, it is always advisable to insert an default statement just like this, unknown response percentage T character underscore code. So you just add a break. This is absolutely fine. Even if you don't have a default case statement, you will not have any runtime error. But here, in addition to it, default cases come in hand for logic checking. For instance, if your switch statement handled a fixed number of conditions and you considered any value outside those conditions to be a logic error, you could insert a default case which would flag that condition. So this thing I would explain it to you with a small example. For instance, just go with printf. Excuse me, while I count to 5000, x equals to 1. While of 1, printf percentage t comma x, if x equals to 5000, go to all done. Go to all done is a label where the jump code jumps to that label and serves whatever is written in at that label. Else x equal to x plus 1, all done. You are closing that and all done, you are serving it as printf. Ooh, that wasn't so bad, was it? So here in this example could have been written much better, avoiding the use of go to statement. So how to write a better function avoiding the go to statement, I'll tell you now. So integer x printf, integer x printf, excuse me, while I count to 5000 for loop x equals to 1, x less than 5000, x plus plus printf percentage d comma x printf. Ooh, that wasn't so bad, was it? As previously mentioned, the long jump and set jump functions implement a non-local go to statement. Go to. When your program calls set jump, the current state of your program is saved in a structure of type jump buff. Yeah, this for just for your information. These things we will learn in some other session. But for just for your information, just remember the current state of your program is saved in a structure of type jump buff. Later, your program can call the long jump function to restore the program state as it was when you called set jump. Unlike the go to statement, the long jump and set jump functions do not need to implement in the same function. However, there is a major drawback to using these functions. Your program, when restored to its previously saved state, will lose its references to a DMA, that is dynamically allocated memory, between long jump and the set jump. This means you will waste memory for every malloc or calloc function you have implemented between your long jump and set jump, and your program will be horribly inefficient. It is highly recommended that you avoid using functions such as long jump and set jump, because they, like the go-to statement, are quite often an indication of poor programming practice. So I will give you with an example, a function with an example of using long jump and set jump. Just let's try to move forward into that example. So include stdio.h and setjump.h, use the libraries. I have a condition based on the direction of pressed, direction pressed. We'll have a switch case statement, whether it is an up cursor or down cursor or left cursor or right cursor. So this is how we write it: switch direction, case up cursor, cursor up, and case down, cursor down, and then cursor left, cursor right, break, default, printf, logic error on line number and percentage d, and give the line and print that line number and break. This is how we would write the long jump, set jump function example. So here you can see a default this thing, but overall I can say, for the question whatever we had, default case is not necessary, but it is always good practice to have a default case whenever you are checking for errors or logic checking purposes. Thank you. I hope this was useful for you. For a switch case statement, I'll come up with the next question. Thank you.